distinguished audience and the heroes in front of us. You know, I was a young journalist when all this was happening. Though I recollect rich people from Kuwait coming in their four-wheel drives, passing through Delhi. And those were the rich refugees. But I didn't know much about the other people who suffered after the occupation of Kuwait started. This documentary is an eye-opener. I was telling Captain Kaikobad, you know, if you give it to a good Malayali film director, he'll make a better film than Airlift. and he was telling me that more than half the passengers were Malayalis. So I think you should explore that possibility. Anyway, I have requested him to write an article for Frontline, and he has agreed to do so. And a lot of people in Kerala will know about this, the adventure of the Safir. I don't know what exactly I have to talk about, but I can give a little bit of background about what happened before the invasion of Kuwait. You know, from 1980 to 1988, there was this war which Iraq fought with Iran, with more than 1 million people died, most of them Iraqis. And in this war, Iraq was encouraged by the Americans to go to war, Americans and their allies in the region, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait. In fact, Saudi Arabia and Kuwait financed Iraq in the war. And after 8 years, with the war at a stalemate, there was a ceasefire. And instead of helping the Iraqi economy revive, the Saudis and the Kuwaitis refused to help Iraq, and in fact demanded that Iraq repay its debt of many billions of dollars. And what angered Iraq especially was the fact that when the Iraqis were dying, the Kuwaitis were stealing Iraqi oil, you know, what's called as, you know, slide drilling. And the Kuwaitis accepted that they did that, but there was some difference of opinion about the compensation we paid. The Iraqis wanted $10 billion. The Kuwaitis said, no, we can only pay $8 billion. So all this led to the invasion of Kuwait. As all of you know, Iraq never recognized Kuwait as an independent country right from the very beginning. They said that the Kuwait is a creation of the British colonial powers. And then also, as the documentary shows, that, you know, Iraqis had a special place for India in their hearts. You know, the photograph of Gujral and Saddam hugging was appreciated in you know, in many by certain sections of the media, but the international media especially was very critical of that hug. They thought that India was surrendering to Iraq. And Iraq, as you know, was one of the important actors in the non-aligned movement. In fact, because of the war with Iran, the non-aligned summit was shifted to Delhi. It was supposed to be held in Baghdad in 1983, Nam summit. So I'm going into a little bit of you know, background into the history to show that you know, the situation in Kuwait was a little complicated, and the Americans had a big role to play in that tragedy, because before invading Kuwait, Saddam thought that he had got a green signal from the Americans. He met the American ambassador, April Glaspie, that's her name. And the impression he got was that the Americans were not really interested in what's happening in the region. They will not interfere. And before that, Donald Rumsfeld had gone and met Saddam, and as you remember, in those days, America was the biggest arms supplier to Iraq. So, but when after the Iran-Iraq war ended in a stalemate, Iraq was left totally isolated, its economy in tatters, and this is one reason why the invasion of Kuwait took place. But as the documentary shows that in some ways the Iraqis did help us, and they had facilitated the movement of the ship, allowed the ship to leave the port. And foreign nationals working in Kuwait, they were also sort of, put in panic mode by the kind of stories, just spread about the Iraqi occupation, like babies being killed in the incubators. All these stories turned out to be totally false. An uncle of mine was in Kuwait, he left, he was one of the rich, Indians, so he had no problem living in Kuwait. But when he left, when he went back to Kuwait, he found his flat was intact, both his cars were in, mint condition. So looting was there, but I think they were just targeted looting. They were looting the Kuwaiti thing, Kuwaiti gold, Kuwaiti property. So this is kind of putting the whole thing in context. So thank you for the excellent documentary, and we hope that we'll hear more about it. The future generation needs to know about this. Thank you very much.